Sure, Fortnite Season 5 may be going strong, but Season 6 will be here in no time with so many changes that'll make your head spin. We've scoured the internet to help break down all the rumors, leaks, and official announcements to give you a little taste of what to expect in the upcoming season. Now, before we begin, subscribe to The Gamer and ring that bell to join our notification squad so you never miss a video. Without further ado, here are some Fortnite Season 6 updates that might change the game. Dirt bikes and motorcycles. During the early seasons of Fortnite Battle Royale, players only had the ability to walk or run around the giant map. Those were the good old days. Then Epic Games introduced shopping carts, and a new method of travel was inserted into the game. During Season 5, transportation was completely revamped again with those awesome ATKs, and you can expect another fun innovation for the release of Season 6. While shopping carts were ideal for duos and ATKs were great for squads, solo players may be able to get their hands on either dirt bikes or motorcycles by the time Season 6 rolls around. Wouldn't that be badass? The single-man vehicles make a lot of sense, considering there's a solo game mode. You'll be able to be riding solo like Jason Derulo. That was a bad, outdated joke. Anyway, the next step in these Fortnite vehicles seems obvious based on a number of skins that have been released. Back in March, the Burnout skin was released and is clearly designed for motorcycle riding. We mean, just look at it. Recently, a pair of skins helped build onto rumors of a motorcycle in the future. Both Whiteout and Overtaker are clear motorcycle outfit skins with pure white helmets, gear, and accessories. Imagine wearing these skins as you cruise through levels on a motorcycle or even try your hand at the racetrack. If motorcycles do get released, expect to see even more rad skins like these. Halloween 2.0. It seems like every month, Fortnite only seems to grow and gain massive amounts of new players. With expansions onto Android and the Nintendo Switch, the only thing you can't play this system on is your toaster. For many of us, we missed our chance to play in the first annual Fortnite Battle Royale Halloween event back in 2017. Not only was everything transformed into a ultra-cool Halloween theme, but players got their hands on some ultra-rare skins people still seek out today. Season 6 will debut just about a month before Halloween hits, so you know Epic Games is gearing up for an even bigger and better bash. Expect to see all kinds of holiday changes to the maps, including a possible haunted house in Haunted Hills.
It's about to get spooky up in here.
The shop will also have tons of Halloween-related items. You can almost guarantee to see some new form of the Skull Trooper returning to the store. You know the skin Myth uses all the time? It was only released during Halloween last year, so it's uber rare. A new version could feature a similar design with some tweaks and upgrades to differentiate it from the original. We may also see some other monster skins in the game, including a werewolf, mummy, and Frankenstein. Ooh, a tie-in with the new release of the Halloween movie could also feature Michael Myers running rampant in Fortnite. Hoverboard. For those Fortnite players who venture over into the Save the World mode, you will notice a number of differences in the game. One of the main ways Save the World differs from Battle Royale is with the inclusion of the hoverboard. It's not like those lame hoverboards everyone used to have that would randomly explode. This hoverboard looks like a skateboard and allows players to travel across the map quicker while still giving them the ability to shoot. After several months of success in the Save the World mode, a hoverboard may end up in the Battle Royale by the time Season 6 rolls around. A hoverboard can be added to the game multiple ways. Players may find the hoverboard sitting around like a shopping cart, or maybe it can only be found in a chest like the best item in the game, the bush. When the hoverboard is equipped, any damage the player takes will instantly knock them off the board, but for many, the speed advantage will be worth it. Just imagine playing a round of squads and rolling into tilted towers on a set of four hoverboards. No one would want to mess with the hoverboard crew, that's for sure. The possibilities are endless. An alien theme. For years now, Fortnite Battle Royale has been hinting at the arrival of aliens in some form. While the Rift has focused a lot on interdimensional time travel and other stuff we don't understand, everything may be associated with the arrival of extraterrestrial beings. One of the biggest signs of an alien arrival? The slow-moving purple cube which randomly appeared in the game. The cube may represent some kind of sophisticated alien technology with all those mysterious symbols and such. Of course, we'll have a lot more information once the giant cube event ends, but until then, we can only speculate how aliens are involved somehow. Once the rift and lightning disappears from the sky, players could find themselves dealing with some sort of alien presence from above. Random UFOs could appear, alien attacks could take place, and we could be seeing a lot more of the strange symbols around the map. Cue the sci-fi theme for Season 6. Either way, it'll be interesting to see what kinds of crazy skins Epic Games will come up with if aliens do become a huge theme in the game. The use of aliens could explain a lot of the time travel elements and reasons why Drift was included in Season 5. Drift could represent the ultimate hero to help take on an alien army. Loot Lake transformed. Every new season of Fortnite comes with major changes to some of our favorite locations. We've seen Dusty Divot go through some crazy makeovers over the past several months, along with a whole new desert area with Paradise Palms replacing the ugly swamp area with Moisty Mire. The area that could undergo some major changes in Season 6 is Tilted Towers. Okay, we're just joking, but we do hate that place. We actually think a major change could happen to boring Loot Lake. After tracking the cube's movements for a few days, several players have determined the cube is on a course for arrival right into the center of Loot Lake. What will happen when the cube becomes fully immersed in the water? Only time will tell, but we think it might involve the Loch Ness Monster, or maybe not. There are so many theories going around, and Redditor Brainer Jr. believes a massive pyramid may be rising up out of the water, and that the lake could break into smaller lakes or rivers. Hey, we're all for an Egyptian theme if that's where things are going. Maybe the cube drains Loot Lake and all of its water. Either way, take some time out of your busy day to take one last dip into Loot Lake, because it could be the final time you get to take a vacation there. Expanded car use. Epic Games just loves to add little details to the game that are there for a lot more than just decoration. In early seasons, we saw shopping carts which players could eventually ride in. Buildings are created for specific reasons, and basketball hoops can now be shot into. One of the main things that fills up our maps? Abandoned cars. We would love to be able to break into these bad boys and speed away like it's Grand Theft Auto. The first time we played Fortnite, we actually thought we could drive these cars. While we could beat the cars up and harvest a nice chunk of metal, Fortnite players have the urge to drive around the world and explore. While we don't see cars becoming a mainstay in the world of Fortnite, we do see them being a part of some type of limited time game mode. We would love to see a twisted metal type of game mode. You could smash into other cars and try to eliminate other drivers. It would be the best thing ever. The Rusty Reels drive-in theater is filled with all types of vehicles to choose from, and the fenced-in area would make a great location for a demolition derby. Even if the small cars aren't available to drive, the large Mack trucks could provide some great ways to transport large groups of people. Imagine piling in 10 or more players into a giant truck for a round of 50 versus 50.
Yeah.
New weapons. The weapon assortment in Fortnite Battle Royale is already impressive, with so many options, but we're greedy and expect even more weapons for Season 6. Thanks to some data miners who scour Fortnite files, some new clues have emerged about the future weapons we may see in Season 6. Let's just say that both of them will pack a lot of heat, if you know what we mean. The first weapon will be the short-range flamethrower. While it may be a little hard to sneak up on an opponent and burn them to a crisp, there's a lot of strategy in getting a flamethrower. In the most likely scenario, a flamethrower will have the ability to quickly destroy walls and forts built by other players, especially if it's a wooden fort. A flamethrower may not be an effective killing machine, but it'll be really fun to use. The second weapon players have data mined is the quad launcher. The quad launcher is like the rocket launcher, but uses four smaller rockets instead of one large one. The four rockets cover a wider area of impact, giving you a big advantage during a build battle or long-range attack. There's no word on whether the weapons are limited-time additions or set to become a permanent part of the game, but we'd love to see them both. Mini-games. Fortnite was a whole different world before Playground Mode was introduced. Back in the day, players used to focus mainly on killing and then teabagging you afterwards to celebrate the kill. Now, the world is packed with all types of mini-games and fun challenges for players to play, including every retired person's favorite game, golf, as well as basketball. As Season 6 arrives, expect to see some more mini-games tossed into the mix. The pickaxe has already been used for a golf club, so why not transform the swing and make it into a baseball bat? As Halloween passes and the holiday season approaches, you may find the soccer fields get replaced with hockey arenas as you shoot giant pucks around with your pickaxe. Playground mode may expand to include more players and a lot of different mini-game challenges. Imagine the fun you could have playing Capture the Flag or Domination in a smaller version of the Fortnite map. Fortnite will remain a battle royale game at its core, but giving players a number of different options gives them plenty more reasons to stick around, especially during the crowded holiday video game season. A Great Flood. So many rumors and theories have popped up involving Season 6 and the use of Loot Lake. From Nessie to giant pyramids, everyone is going nuts. While many assume the lake is getting smaller, others predict an even bigger disaster, a massive flood. A giant lake flood would cover a much bigger part of the land and change a lot of the game dynamics. We could get water vehicles like boats, have to build all types of forts over the water, and have a lot less land to explore. Assassin's Creed 4, Black Flag-style naval combat would be amazing. We hope you could even put your flag on the ship. It would be good old swashbuckling fun. We'd be so down for a pirate theme in Season 6 as well. The Great Flood and expansion of water makes a lot of sense considering the skins and shop items we've seen in recent months. We've seen the Laser Chomp Glider, which you can combine with the Chomp Senior skin and the Chomp Junior harvesting tool to show how much you appreciate sharks. There's just so many water-themed skins to choose from. Epic Games typically doesn't do things for no reason. Only time will tell what'll happen to Loot Lake, but hopefully a lot of the lifeguard skins are ready to go if something crazy does occur. Time-traveling dinosaurs. For months, Fortnite players have put together clues about the introduction of dinosaurs. Large footprints were spotted overhead, and signs of time travel appeared all over the game. The presence of dinosaurs was partially confirmed in Fortnite Season 5 when a collection of dinosaur statues appeared in the game. While a T-Rex isn't chopping his way through opponents, the statues of the dinosaurs could be just the beginning for these prehistoric creatures. Rumors and theories have spread online over a possible limited time mode where moving dinosaurs roam the map. You'd have to somehow survive in this world full of giant carnivores while avoiding enemy fire at the same time. Just don't shoot a dinosaur because things might get ugly fast. The dinosaurs would fit great into a game of squads or 50 versus 50. We can't imagine dinosaurs being a regular part of the game besides the statues we've already seen. A fun LTM game would be great to try out and showcase how wildlife could be introduced to the game. Plus, imagine all the XP you could earn by tracking down and killing a T-Rex. Hey, it's just an idea, PETA. Don't threaten to sue us. And there you have it. What Season 6 updates do you want to see the most? Do you think that there's too many updates and changes? Let us know in the comments section below. And don't forget to subscribe to The Gamer for more videos just like this one. Thanks for watching.